What is up, women and gentle
women?
Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today I'm bringing you my deck profile from this past weekend at locals. We went undefeated and won this pretty awesome mat, so that's pretty cool. The mat's gonna be up for sale if anybody wants it. I don't think I'm gonna keep it, but I'm probably gonna sell it on eBay. You'll be able to find it if I do decide to sell it at my wife's eBay page. I'll go ahead and link that in the description below. But this weekend I took Burning Abyss. We took pure BA, not PK fire. So we also got this boy out of our entry packs. So that's pretty nice. We're going to sit on him for a while. But so all in all, a good tournament. But yeah, we won this cool little map. So I'm going to bring you a deck profile. This mat here. Is also going to be up for sale. I'll post a better picture on the screen here in editing, but these mats are also up for sale. My wife just hand drew these and we got them printed, and they're up for sale on her website. I'll have that linked in the description below. Yeah, it's a pretty awesome play mat. They're all rubberized. They're limited while supplies last, so if you guys want to get one of these awesome play mats, go ahead and check out the links in the description. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into the deck profile. So we played pure BA, so we'll start out with the main deck. For monsters, let me grab all of them out. You played the obvious triple tour guide and triple rhino warrior. These are our normal summons. We were playing, I think the final count of the deck was 46 cards. So we went with 6 normal summons, which I think is fine. Honestly, any of the BAs are a normal summon. So, like, any 2 BAs is full combo. Tour Guide or Rhino can be combo. Well, Rhino with any other BA, and then Tour Guide by itself is, like, full combo. Depends on, like, how you want to set it up. But, yeah, these cards are really good. This sending back check is always really nice. It came up a lot this weekend at locals. Next up, we have the Burning Abyss, which are 3 graph. 2 Seer, 2 Skarm, 2 Farfa, 1 Barbar, 1 Calcab, and 1 Libic. I ended up cutting the Alec today for this weekend, and I ended up actually missing it. It came up once this weekend, but like, it's not that big of a deal. So I feel like it and Calcab are very interchangeable. This forces your opponent, you're in the Eldritch matchup, to actually activate the cards before they want to. So, like, you can kind of force them into activating their cards with your Alec. Libic lets you extend through when you draw one of these that you didn't want to draw. So, like, you can use this to extend through and still get their effects. Barbar is still relevant. There was multiple times in the tournament this weekend where I utilized Barbar to win games. I used Barbar to win my round one matchup because I was playing against trains. I got my opponent down to, I think it was 2,000 life points. He clacked back with his play and got me down to, I think like 1,200 life points. But I go Tour Guide, he goes Judgment, I go Fiend Griefing, I think I Grieving, or I did something else. I had a trap card, I activated it, and he Judgmented it again, pretty much thinking he sealed the game by doing so. But that put him down to 500 life. I go activate Foolish Burial, send Barbar, banish 3, he chains IDP. Summoning back one of my targets, which was, so summon back the Skarm, and then the other 3 got banished. And the other 3 got banished and burned him for 600, and I won that game because of that. So Barbar still comes up. There's been times where, like, I was playing against Eldritch in the finals, and I ended up searching this off of Skarm in the end phase for my discard fodder for Dragoons, and he was at, six or 900 life. So if he would have activated any card, I could just go Goons, negate, send Barbar, burn for whatever. So that won me that game. So Barbar is still very relevant. It comes up all the time to close out games. Skarm obviously searches you whatever you need out of the deck. I don't think you need more than 2. 2 was plenty for me this weekend. I never wanted more. 2 Farfa was good.
I want to play three, but I don't think three's the right number. I feel like two's the right number, but like there's times where like a third one would have been nice, but like I don't think it's necessary. The same thing that goes with Seer. Like three would be nice, but like I feel for consistency reasons you have to play it at two. And Graph, it's Graph. You play it at three just because it gets you to everything else in the deck. Last bit of the monsters, you pay the one Backjack, who's an honorary BA. If you don't know what this card does, when he's sent to the graveyard, you look at the top three cards of your deck, put them in any order that you'd like. And then as a quick effect, he can banish himself from the graveyard to set, excavate the top card of your deck. If it's a normal trap card, you can immediately set it. So he pretty much stacks the top of your deck and lets you set, get an extra trap, which is really nice. So there's a lot of times where I'll like go for my combo, go normal tour guide summon Rhino, Link into Cherubini, Rhino effects in Backjack, stack a card on top of the deck, special summon out a BA from hand to a zone, Cherubini points to, use Backjack to set the trap that I stacked on top of my deck, then use Cherubini to send, say, a Graph or a Seer or something to, or say, a sent, words, Joseph. Use Cherubini, send Graph, summon Graph, and then continue the full combo, and then you get a free, you just get free cards out of sending this. More interruptions on their turn. And then since we were playing the Dragoons package, we played the one Dark Magician and one Red Eyes. I want to get a better copy of Red Eyes. This thing's so ugly. I hate the gold rares. But this, I like to have an ulti Dark Magician. It's kind of cool. But yeah, that's it for the monsters. On to spells. We only played three spell cards. We played one Pot of Prosperity. This would be a three of if I had three, but I've only got one. So in supplement of that, we played the one Foolish Burial. This card's broke, and then the Red Eyes Fusion, the obvious break. I've drawn this so many times, like, I think at least once a match I drew this weekend, so, like, it's kind of insane to do it that way, too. Like, I just, like, hard drew it in a 46 card deck. I draw one of common, which you're not supposed to do, but I hard drew it a lot this weekend and was able to, like, activate Red Eyes Fusion, set three cards passed. it was kind of insane. Prosperity was okay this weekend. I only activated it once. I only saw it once. I activated it and resolved it once. It didn't get me there. So, like, I feel like in theory the card's insane. So it's definitely worth it if you can afford to get it. I've only got one currently because I sold my playset when the ban list first came out, thinking that the price was going to plummet. I didn't expect it to go up, but here we are. On to traps. We played the three trap trick because we're playing Burning Abyss. It's when we're playing trap BA. You want to have a bunch of trap cards. We played triple Imperm because I don't have IDPs. I need to get IDP. But honestly, I don't know if I'm going to take this out, even if I get it. This card was like actually insane this weekend. I was able to stop Dragoons from coming out. Chain this to Vert and just like, no, tell him to like, no, you can't make a Goons, sorry. This locking out cards, like in the train matchup, this was very relevant because I was able to lock out some of his interactions with by using Imperm. Same thing with the Eldritch matchup. I had an Imperm set and had no other cards on the field, so I was just like, Imperm, target your target your Zeus, because he ended on like Zeus set two pass or some shit. So I had this already set after he like cleared my whatever board I had established. I was like, just like, okay, Imperm the Zeus and clear it and go. Like I cleared the Zeus and then just like got into the, well, that's the game that I got into the situation to where I searched Barbar in end phase, leaving him with like 600 to 900 life, and then like if he would have activated literally any card, just pitch Barbar with Goons, negate, burning for 900. So this card was actually insane. So even when I get IDPs, I don't think I'm taking this out. I really like Imperm right now, especially since Calamity's out of the format. This card just like really good. Like it does so much. I don't understand why people are cutting it. Like it was very, very powerful this weekend. Next up, we three Fiend Grieving. This card needs no explaining. It's another starter in the deck. It does so much on your opponent's turn. It interacts with their graveyard, disrupts their graveyard, as well as like setting you up. So like it sends Graph, it sends Farfa, it sends Seer. It does so much for you that this card is absolutely insane. We played the three Torrential Tribute. This card was like good. It did work today. When I saw it, I never searched it off a trap trick. I never felt like it was necessary. This card is actually insane, and that would be the triple needle sailing. This card is actually insane. It, like, you can just, like, wait to use this until the exact moment, which is, like, why it's better than torrential, because everybody's, like, summon a bunch of things. Like, this thing's so good. Like, I highly recommend you play needle sealing in your Burning Abyss decks. Next three of, we play three Dynamiscus and two Karma Cut. So this is basically saying we're going to play five Dynamiscus. This is better because it targets everything. You can get rid of like Mystic Mines and shit with it. This is good removal period. This has its purposes where it's better. For instance, I was playing against, in the Eldritch matchup, I was trying to, it didn't work. Because they were able to, they had the interaction to blink around it. But the theory was, like, you can take, if they, once they have Golden Boy up, you can just, like, Karma Cut the Golden Boy and get all the Golden Boys out of there, and then you don't have to worry about Golden Boy anymore. It missed on that one, but, like, there's other times today, or this weekend, that this was actually relevant to where I was able to use Karma Cut to banish all of the copies of, say, like, Torn Scales or stuff like that, and just, like, completely warp the game and the game state and how it worked the rest of the day. For that game or whatever. And then finally we played the three Solemn Strike because it's strike. It's really good, this format, in my opinion, because we're playing a trap deck. But that's it for the main deck. I believe it was 46 cards. If I had IDPs and the three Pot of Prosperities, it would be a 50-card deck. But once I get IDPs, we're going to go up to 49 and then decide on whether or not I'm going to put a 40... or a 50th card in the deck. Extra deck, we got the Field Center and our tokens. We play two Dantes, and it's Dante. He does Dante things. We no longer go and, like, mill three. We just summon him, mill one to get the material off of him, and either make a Beatrice with him or link him off for a Vert, and then Vert make goons, that whole thing, and then he adds back a card to hand. Normally you make him with Seer under him, so then you go like him and Cherubini into Vert. Seer, bring back Dante. Dante, add back a dude, whatever you want to add back. Vert summon goons, or you can make Beatrice over this. It's whatever your preference is. I've only summoned Beatrice once this weekend. Like, it's not necessary, but like it's still good to have the option there. We played the one Fortune Tune. This came up this weekend where you just like crash this into something and then make a goons on top of it, or not a goons, but a Zeus on top of it. I never used it for the grind game aspect. Never really had to, so that's that. We played the one Downard for the Zeus, one Beatrice because it's Beatrice, and then the one Zeus. That's it for the exceeds. We played the one Link Spider to clear the Dynamiscus off the board if we needed an effect monster to make the Vert. One Cherubini because it's Cherubini, he broke the Vert. We played IP, never summoned it. We played Nightmare Phoenix, never summoned it. We played Topologic Trisbania, summoned it once, didn't even activate the effect. Boral Sword Dragon, never summoned it. Goon, summoned it literally every game. And then Pimp Dante, we never summoned it. That's it for the extra deck. On to the side deck. Got the three Lancia because my locals is flooded with PK Fire and Eldritch and like all kind of like banishing type decks. This card just very overpowered right now. One Pankratops to deal with the Winda if we play against Invokes at all. Pank's just a broken card. Three Nib because it's Nib. It's broke. It's good. Three Dark Roller no more. That way, if when we're playing against like decks that say no, you can't play the game, then no, I want to play the game, and I'm gonna break your board and then let you deal with the goons. That's what this deck does. It's like break boards and tell you to deal with goons. I decided to play three Twin Twisters, a Harpy's Duster, and an Imperial Order. Twins was just like, this is a flex spot. I was loaning out another deck to somebody today, and this is what I threw in so to give them some extra side deck cards. Like, these are staple for like Eldritch matchups, any kind of like back row decks, or like any kind of like heavy spell reliant decks. And then these are just like spot removal cards. These are very flexing. They can be whatever you'd like. But that's the deck. We went undefeated today, 4-0. We played Trains round 1, Dinosaur round 2. So we 2-0 Trains, we 2-1 Dinos, then we played PK Fire, we 2-0 PK Fire, and then we played Eldritch in the finals, and we 2-1 them. And that was the matchups, man. Like, the deck performed very well. I'm very happy with it. Got the job done. I'm going to start doing profiles of, like, every time I go undefeated at locals. And put them up. I've got some interesting decks I'm going to be coming up with. I've got a few spicy ideas that's going to be coming through the pipeline. I won't be able to go to locals next weekend, so don't expect a deck profile next week. But there will be some kind of Yu-Gi-Oh! Content. But I've got a spicy deck that I'm going to be taking to locals the next time I'm able to go. Because thankfully, our locals is open with, like, COVID restrictions. We have to follow protocol, so don't worry, we're being safe. Everybody's washing their hands, we're social distancing, we're doing everything that we can to be safe. So we're very fortunate with that. Yeah, I hope everybody stays.